Well, did you improve the crown? There was plenty of time.
Almost. Just a little more time to finish some things.
So quickly, get on with it. The witch is almost in our hands. I'm counting on you.
I must quickly go to Nimeril. I hope I can find the map that his father used. Hey, did you manage to find a clue?
Yes. There are some numbers, squares. I don't understand anything. I hope you'll understand.
I still don't get it. Maybe there is some clue on the back?
I saw a stencil with the same symbol on my dad's shelves.
Judging by the images, this clue should help to open the cache. I wanted coins of different denominations to open this door. I can try to exchange coins at Godeloth's store for the denomination I need. Can you exchange this coin? I need one for 25 and one for 8.
I can exchange 50 for 25 and 25, but 8 is a very rare coin. I held it in my hands only once, when I bought a ticket from Wandering Artists. But alas, I already sold it. Thank you.
Dad moved the crown over this map and looked through it at the figures.
It doesn't work. Probably this is because some details are missing. There is a basket of candy in the tavern. Maybe I can find the right candies there. Hello. May I take some candy from your counter?
Of course. You helped to save my son. I am indebted to you. Is there any other way I can help?
Are these candies in the basket the only ones you have? I need another one in the shape of a swan.
Look in the pantry. I have a lot of them. I usually don't put everything in the basket.
Thank you.
must be the way to the witch's house. There is a pond with swans and a clearing with wild strawberries in the forest near the hunter's place. I need to go there with this map.
The gingerbread map worked. The crown with the compass opened a portal to the witch's hideout. Leonore closely followed the movement of the revived gingerbread man and repeated his route exactly. One mistake, and the house would have remained hidden, as it would be in front of Magnus and other residents. The magic of the map led her to the right place, and the witch's house opened before her. It was so deep in the forest that she would have had to walk for several days without the portal. When Leonore looked out of the forest, she saw with her own eyes how the witch, wrapped in a robe, grabbed the boy and locked him in a magical trap.
It's another kidnapped child. I have to free him. The witch hid the child somewhere around here. But how can I open a passage to the bunker? Thank you.
Leonore dispelled the witchcraft and opened the trap. But as soon as she took the boy by the hand to take him away, familiar shadows enveloped him. The witch ran out of the house and desperately shouted after her son.
Why? Why did you bring evil into this forest? Why did you give my son right into its clutches?
But I thought it was you. Everyone in the settlement is talking about the witch and the gingerbread.
I do not understand anything. Why were you looking for me?
There are missing children in Forest Hill. They were carried away by the shadows after eating the enchanted gingerbread. There is a legend in the town about the witch who kidnaps children, and everyone thinks it's you.
Me? I have never kidnapped other people's children. Even 200 years ago, they came across my house and started to gnaw it, then ran away as soon as they saw me. Show me those gingerbreads. These are not my gingerbreads. I don't make them like this. It seems that someone specifically wanted to make everyone suspect me.
Why did you try so hard to hide them?
We, dragon lords, have a very strong bond with children because of the magic in our blood. Disturbing visions began to haunt me relentlessly. I wanted to keep us safe from any kind of magic.
Visions? What was in these visions?
I can show you. I have sketched every vision in this book.
I know this place. It's a tapestry in Magnus's house. I need to go there and check it out.
Visions of the future can be a gift or a curse.
What was that? I need to get back to the witch. She may know that magic and how to deal with it. I came to Magnus's house. There was a secret door behind the tapestry from the vision. But as soon as I pulled the handle, I was attacked by the same shadows as the children.
Shadows? Such magic has been banned for a long time. He must be hiding something really rotten.
Is there any way to remove this spell from the door?
I can help you see the spell, but I don't know how to help you remove it. You're not a magician, and I definitely shouldn't be in the town.
Is there any way for me to do it?
I'm sure that there is. I have a few books about magic in my chest. You can look through them. Surely people have come up with some kind of artifact for this.
How can I see the spell?
The candies in my yard are not quite ordinary. They have many features. If you cut off a piece of candy, make a lens out of it, and soak it in black water, such a lens will reveal any spell, even the darkest one.
How can I make this black water?
I will prepare the black water myself. It is difficult. And you take care of the lens. I hope you can find a way in the books to remove the spell after you reveal it.
I need something very sharp to separate part of the candy. Beniker probably has the right tool in the clearing.
Here is black water. Put the lens in the bowl and fill it with water so that the lens is well saturated.
I saw the place in the picture. These are ruins at the bottom of the cave lake. I need to examine them to find the crystal. Visions of the future can be a gift or a curse. This book may hold the key to unraveling what is going on. It remains to figure out how to turn off the protective field. I need to tell the witch about this dark ritual. What happened?
I tried to find my son with magic. I got to the cave when the dark defense attacked me. The potion restored some of my strength, but I lost my sight. Hopefully not forever, but definitely for a long time.
I found a strange magical book at Magnus's. It says that the sacrifice of the four races can break some kind of seal, and that the ritual must be performed under the blood moon.
Security seal. That's why he needs the kids. It turns out this is definitely the work of Magnus. Who would have thought? You will have to try to stop him alone because the blood moon will rise tonight in 5 hours.
What should I do? We don't have the slightest idea where he is or where the children are.
Before the magic attacked me, I reached a stone with the symbol of air. I think it leads to the ritual site. Take this symbol. I hope it leads you to the answer.
I saw a strange astronomical instrument in Magnus's house with a similar pattern in the center. judging by the recesses. I need to place 5 certain elements in this mechanism to use it. It seems to be a stone from the pedestal in the cave, but it is broken. Can the witch know? I found and assembled the stone. It is large, smooth, and has a griffin painted on it. Do you know what might be special about it? Perhaps it will be possible to open a passage to the ritual site with the help of 5 such stones.
Sounds like star stones. I think they can be found with the help of a magic ritual. It is unlikely they have protection.
Can I do this ritual?
Yes. The stone must be placed in the center of the map, on the table, and purple candles should be lit. Points on the map will tell you where the rest of the stones will be. But first, you need to get the support of the hunter. You cannot help by yourself, and no one in town will go against the elder. However, Benegger lives on the outskirts for a reason. Magnus once framed him up and blackened him in front of all of the residents.
So that's what this is about. That explains a lot. I'll go to him.
When you go to Benegger, ask him for a new purple candle. He should definitely have one.
Benegger, it's Magnus. Magnus kidnapped the kids. I know where he went, but I need help to save them.
I knew. I told everyone that something was off with him. Nobody believed me. That's what it all came to. Okay, I'll help.
And one more thing. The witch said you have a purple candle.
The witch? Her name is Akra, and I have a candle. Look in the clearing. I'll get ready at that time.
left before the rising of the red moon.
Akra, good to see you. Are you okay?
So, that's the ritual that these candles are made for. I've never seen it.
Move away. I'll deal with them now.
Try to use a knife. This resin should break easily.
I have 3 more hours before the red moon rises.
Look, a drawing appeared on the rock.
Everything seems to be too simple. I need to check if there is some kind of protective spell here as well.
Leonor and Beniger went out to the site of the ritual. Beniger demanded he hand over the children, but Magnus did not respond. It was no longer Magnus. Someone else controlled him. He brought down the stone on the bridge with a powerful spell. Leonor managed to run away, but the hunter stood too close. He couldn't stay on the fragments of the bridge and fell into the cliff. Magnus went deeper into the cave, as if nothing had happened.
The red moon will rise in an hour. I need to get back to the Dragonoid. There! Magnus. He turned into someone different. He brought down the bridge with magic. Beniger fell off the edge of a cliff. There's no way to get to the ritual site now.
Poor fellow. But the children are still alive. We need to come up with an idea of how to save them. Is there something long enough to reach the other end of the cliff?
I need to remember. There is a statue. If I blow up its base, it will fall, and it will be possible to walk over it. I just recently took a special liquid from the blacksmith.
Explosive liquid can provoke a large-scale collapse. But you can use an exploding crystal with it. If you make a bomb, then the explosion will be local.
I can take explosive liquid from Rongrim again. Do you have a vessel to pour it into?
I must have something suitable. Look in the next room. There you will find all the necessary instructions. You can handle it. The future is not set in.
I got the explosive liquid. There are 2 instructions on the wall that will help me to figure out how to make a bomb.
Thank you.
Leonore entered the cave as the moons merged, and bloody light filled everything. Magnus was consumed by the ritual.
Magnus is engrossed in the ritual and doesn't see me. I'll try to free the kids before he notices me. Been removed from the child. Consciousness regaining will take time, but I will use it to free the others.
Leonor freed the children with the help of a glove and commanded them to get ready and run together out of the cave. When Magnus felt that the magic was weakening, he turned to find out the reason and saw Leonor. Magnus cast a destructive spell on her, but the protective bracelet saved the girl. It surrounded her with a shield that took the damage away. Magnus prepared to cast his spell again, but Benegar appeared from behind, grabbed him, and dived into the ritual well with him. There was no time to think. The magic dissipated, and Leonor led the last child, the son of the fisherman, to the exit. The well erupted, and a magical explosion rocked the cave. Everything around started to fall apart. Leonor saved all four children. It seemed like a good ending to a terrible story, but no one guessed that this was not the end. It was necessary to sacrifice the blood of all four races to remove the seal. Magnus's plan failed, but despite everything, the conditions of the ritual were still fulfilled. Distant ancestors of Magnus were Shimu and Dragonoids, and Benegar's ancestors were dwarves and humans. Therefore, their blood was enough for the ritual. The first seal was broken, and the Grey Overlord was one step closer to returning to this world. When the jubilation about the return of the children subsided, Leonor decided to stay in the town. She became the local herbalist and alchemist instead of Magnus. The inhabitants of the town gave her land to build her own house. Life in Forest Hill continued to go on as usual.